media viewer, welcome to yet another episode of Decent Conversations with your girl Tabby. And today I want us to have a simple conversation in relation to mental health. And the topic that I want to talk about is mental red alerts. And by mental red alerts, I mean mental triggers or mental signals that we have that tell us that something is wrong. And these signals, we only get them when we are self-aware about the issues that will trigger us, probably to feel sad, to feel depressed, to feel anxiety. So there are those like mental red alerts that we get. And in such an instance, I would like to share my own experience in the context of my mental red alerts. And I'm doing this after I was challenged by one of the viewers who wanted to see how practical the lessons I'm sharing are and how I'm applying them myself. And the mental red alerts is something that I'm applying myself. So today I had a low moment. I was feeling kind of low. I was feeling like I'm getting some negative vibes. And it really pulled me down. I didn't feel like doing anything. I just wanted to lay down. You know, I really didn't have energy. And being a creative person, I relied so much on having energy, positive energy, so that I can be able to come up with new ideas, look at things to do, things to write, you know, read, and even research. But when I get those moments where I'm feeling low, I just want to sit in my room and just lie down and do nothing, those to me become red alerts. Because normally I'm somebody who's very jovial, interacting with people. And the downside is I spend so much time on my phone or maybe on my laptop, especially when I'm doing creative things like writing or any other kind of content. So today when I had my down moment, I really needed something to cheer me, to kind of to dispose of all the negative vibes and re-energize. So I really needed a physical activity, not really a mental activity. I'm very good with mental activity and I have very little physical activity. So in such a case, when I feel low, I want to transfer my energy to something that will rejuvenate me. So I tend to do something physical. It doesn't have it can be any kind of physical activity. This can be going out to run, to take a walk, to jog, dancing, jumping. And I just thought of going to the farm. Yeah, I'm not really a farmer, but I thought, why not just go to the farm and unwind and, you know, and just relax, enjoy nature, and do something physical and manual that would really use my energy, so that I will just, you know, transfer that energy, the negative energy, into something productive. So yeah, I went to the farm, and this is the time I'm leaving the farm. It's quite late, it's 7 o'clock. So I've been in the farm just doing a bit of plowing and clearing bushes, and I really feel rejuvenated and energetic. And I want to challenge you, my viewer, to begin and listen to yourself. Listen to your inner self to the point of when something is off, you will be the first person to know. Because when it comes to mental health, it's quite unfortunate because most of the time we do not realize that we are not in a good space until someone else points it out. So for us, it becomes a normal behavior of withdrawing, being by yourself, being quiet. By the time you get to know it, it becomes a habit. And you say, when probably people will start asking you, you'll be like, yeah, but that's how I am, I enjoy it, you know, or you will just be defensive about it. But when you become aware of your mental red alerts, you're able to take action before it's too late, or before you get into a deep state of depression that will really take a lot of energy and time to pull yourself out. So we all have different alerts. For me, I know when I have no energy to do anything, for me, that's an alert. Any moment that I lose interest in the things that give, I lose interest in the things that give me joy and fulfillment, I know that's a red alert. Anytime I don't want to talk to anyone, I know that's a red alert. So become self-aware. If you really, when it comes to mental health, one thing that I really emphasize is self-awareness. Because you will know how you react to things, you will know how to behave, you will know what makes you feel this way, what makes you feel sad, what makes you feel happy, which now makes you have a healthy mind. So when you have a healthy mind, you become more productive. And for me, I become more creative. And I really want you to take on the challenge of trying to see how do you behave, how to react to situations, and you really know your red alerts. Know your red alerts and now prepare to act anytime your mind gives you that red alert. And when you do that, you'll be able to tackle issues before they become difficult and heavy to you. Yeah, thank you. That has been our conversation on mental red alerts. Make sure you subscribe to my channel and also share your comments in the comment sections and ideas. And you can even share your experience with mental health. Yeah, that has been a conversation.